Back in May of this year, the Atlas V rocket lifted off the pad carrying a secret space plane into orbit. Operated by the US Space Force, the X-37 has spent 8 of the last 10 years in space. Now it is looking to beat its previous record and test out a new form of technology which could have a massive impact here on Earth. The X-37 will perform the first ever test of a solar power farm in space. The idea is that a large solar array in space could gather an enormous amount of energy from the sun and wirelessly transmit power to anywhere on Earth. This idea has been around for a while, but the cost of actually launching and testing something this large has always been too high, until now. Due to the incredibly low cost of the Falcon 9, SpaceX are starting to revolutionize the broadband industry with their gigantic constellation of internet satellites. With space becoming more and more accessible, it could allow energy companies to move their business into space. On a perfectly sunny day, a 1 by 1 meter of land on Earth would typically receive around 250 watts of power from the sun. Even the most efficient solar panels can only turn about 20% of that energy into electricity. A solar panel in space would receive more than double the amount of power from the sun since it isn't being blocked by our atmosphere. As the sun's energy hits the solar panel, it gets converted into electricity. That electricity could then be converted into a microwave signal and beamed wirelessly down to Earth. These microwaves could be transmitted at a specific frequency, allowing them to pass through the clouds without causing harm to life on Earth. In order to receive this power, a large farm of antennas would be built on the ground to convert the incoming microwaves into electricity. As the microwaves travel down to Earth, they spread out over a large distance. This means that the farm would need to be several kilometers wide in order to harness all of the power. But instead of transmitting this power to the ground, what if we used it to power airplanes? Although many industries have moved over to more renewable energy sources, the airline industry still faces a massive challenge in the form of energy density. An airplane stores its energy in the form of fuel, while an electric plane stores its energy in batteries. In order to store the same amount of energy, an electric airplane ends up almost 40 times heavier due to the amount of batteries it needs. For an airplane, this extra weight drastically reduces how far it can fly and how many passengers it can hold. Recently, an electric Cessna airplane took to the skies over Washington to perform its first ever test flight. This is the world's largest electric passenger plane, but it can only carry 9 passengers, a distance of 160 kilometers. But what if we could remove most of the batteries from an electric plane and provide a constant source of power throughout the flight? While a solar farm in space could beam power down to Earth, it could theoretically beam the power to moving targets like planes, ships, and even other satellites in orbit. In order to maximize the amount of power being sent to an aircraft, the power could be converted into laser light instead of microwaves and beamed directly onto the plane's solar array. This would allow more power to be transferred in a much narrower beam. Since planes fly well above the thickest part of our atmosphere, things like clouds and fog wouldn't get in the way of the power beam. This would allow the plane to have much smaller receivers than those used on the ground. A constellation of solar farms placed in a geostationary orbit could provide constant power even to an aircraft flying through the night. Although an electric plane would still need a battery pack for takeoff and landing, the majority of the batteries could be stripped out and replaced with cabin space for passengers and cargo. Once the plane is above the clouds, the solar farm would lock onto the moving aircraft and start beaming power continuously to the plane's solar arrays. This may seem like a crazy idea from the future, but most of the technologies involved have already been tried and tested. Back in 2003, NASA engineers flew a model airplane by beaming a 10-kilowatt laser at its solar array. In 2008, engineers beamed 20 watts of power from a mountaintop in Maui down to a receiver 150 kilometers away on the island of Hawaii. The experiment on board the X-37 will be the first ever real-life test of a solar power farm in space. Despite the amazing benefits a solar farm in space would offer, the cost to develop all these different technologies is still too high. But with space becoming a playground for private companies, it seems almost inevitable that one day we'll be harnessing the enormous amounts of energy just outside our atmosphere. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.